But yeah, here we are. The version 4.4 special program is going to begin soon. And with it, it's going to come Xianyun, Gaming, and probably the new Lantern Rite event that's going to come in this update. Not sure what else to expect, but other than like maybe a few reruns of the Liwei characters like Gan Yu, Hu Tao, and Zhongli, and maybe some news about the anime and maybe a new skin here and there. Who knows? 3, 2, 1, let's go!
Have you ever heard of wushou dancing?
Ooh, trailer. Hey, I think that...
Liyue Harbor is always...
Wushou, that's Gaming. So yeah, that's Gaming.
That Lantern Rite should change in turn.
Wushou dancing is famous in Chunyu Vale. Performers might be invited to...
Oh, yeah, Chunyu Vale as well. Right, I almost forgot about that.
Spread good fortune during a holiday season.
Yep, Lantern Rite's back. Oh, Shoya's here!
Is that so?
You're quite right, Miss Hu Tao. You're quite right, Miss Hu Tao.
Oh, is Gami just on the water?
How about we grab some dim sum?
Hey, okay, he is a 4-star. Oh my! Oh, you can actually use that thing in his kit. Oh, he's a Claymore character.
Congratulations!
Oh, I want to play him already.
Up to it,
please tell
back.
Me he's like Hazo, and he can like be a DPS. Oh, this is Chenyu Vale. Okay, so we're getting a Liwei expansion.
Always tied down, no matter how far it flies or how high.
Wait, is that a new skin for Ganyu and Shenhe?
Oh, kite born of paper, flying.
That's a new outfit for Ganyu and Shenhe. Oh fuck, my money is gone.
I always believed we would see each other again.
Aww.
That our days of separation finally.
There she is. Oh god, she has another weird domain for us again.
I don't know.
Whoa, what the fuck?
I don't remember.
Is that a tiger enemy?
You chose a path without a future.
Dude. Oh, I'm guessing these are like...
Spare my innocent child. I alone am the source of this sin.
Oh, that's a new weekly boss. Oh, no, not weekly boss, but just a normal boss. Oh, shit. Holy shit, that's a cool looking boss. Yeah, there she is, Xianyun. Oh, okay, so she's a catalyst user, okay. Oh, damn, those animations though. Oh, wait, is she flanking? Oh, please tell me you can fly with her, like, oh yeah, she has a bird form in her kit. Please tell me you can, like, fly with her, like, with Wanderer. But, yep. Okay, there's your update. Vibrant Harrius, aloft in spring breeze. Okay, so that's a lot. Ganyu and Shenhe outfits. Lantern Rite, Xianyun. Charlotte's in Liwei for some reason. And yeah, the new area. Yeah, Chaoying Village. Open the way forward for the way. Holy shit, that was a lot that happened in that trailer. Springtide of Xiaoying. Oh, is this like new OST for the area? So yeah, finally we're getting like a Liwei expansion. I mean, the chasm was kind of a Liwei expansion, but you know what I mean. Oh, I like the music already. Part of me wonders if that background is like actually made like that. Like if they actually created it or if that's just CGI. If that's CGI, that's just some damn good CGI.
Hello, 虽然具体在哪听过有点记不太清了，不过印象里是和茶有关。
Yeah, Chaoying Village has been like teased in Genshin, and yeah, Chenyu Village as well has been teased in Genshin for a while now. And many people are like wondering when we're gonna get it. I guess we're getting this update.这么厉害啊！毕竟这个茶壶相传是先人留下的仙家机关嘛，用它炒出的茶叶香气和口味确实是挺不一般的。
而且坊间都流传，俏英庄的水土得到过仙人的护佑，原本就特别适合茶叶生长。哪怕不去考虑仙家机关的加持，茶叶本身的品质就已经非常不错了。
虽然我不是什么品茶的这个专业人士啊，但我知道同样挑选上等的茶叶，这茶叶啊也会因为各种因素的影响。
You're just talking about tea right now. Also, can you guys hear the stream okay? Is it good? Can you hear it well? 炒出的茶是什么味道？Also, yeah, I'm assuming those like cool looking domains are like more domains that should like that Cloud Retain like made for us. Oh yeah, damn, look at that. Welcome to the rice fields, motherfucker. Xianyun, okay, so that's how you pronounce it. Although, shouldn't be start with a G?
还有啊，说到嘉明这个名字啊，听着就很亲切。
嘉明他的性格热情。
Yeah, that sounds pronounced in Chinese.
大家也很喜欢和他相处。虽然
说，But as we call him gaming.
但他人却经常在璃月港和仪龙部两地之间往返。他的主业是镖师，还有个副业是表演武兽戏。
还有副业啊？
年轻人的精神比较好。
那我猜啊
Man's a busy kid. At least I assume he's a kid. It's hard to tell. Hey, there he is. Star Wars Strider. Guard of Sword and Strongbox. Oh yeah, we've read this about his lore.
还跟家里人闹得不太开心。不过嘉明对武兽戏还真不是。
Caleb Yen. Okay, I recognize a voice actor. Where else has he been? I recognize Caleb Yen as a voice actor. I just don't know where I've seen him before.
这也是为了证明给家里看吧。最终他离开了家去追求梦想，虽然现在的生活有点
Actually, wait, no.
但嘉明
Isn't he Kalos in Star Rail?
感觉他真的很有
Or somebody else in Star Rail, I think.
机会还真挺想去看看他的武兽戏，
机会说不定已经近在眼前了哦。
哦，这感情好啊。
嘉明这么喜爱武兽戏，他的技能天赋当然也和他有关了。要不然我就先给大伟哥介绍介绍，也算是提前满足一下你的好奇了。
原来是这么个近在眼前啊，可以可以。
Whether it takes me uphill, downhill, hey, there he is.
I get the goods from A to B.
I like that little dragon head he like just carries around with him.
Don't worry, you're in safe hands. They don't call me the gold standard guard for nothing.
Oh yeah, yeah, that's some pretty fucking cool animations for a claymore. He just slams a dragon head on him.
Congratulations.
Oh wow, his playstyle looks fun. Oh, and he has a little dragon hoodie as well.
嘉明会将自己的武兽之法应用在各种场合。
Yeah, damn, look at those animations though. I hope he's a main DPS.
在接触到目标或地形时向上。
Oh, you can jump with him, or like super jump, I guess.
强劲的下落。
啊。
对敌人造成火元素伤害。不过以这种形式释放的下落攻击，会使嘉明在落地时消耗。
Oh, okay, so he.
Huh,
so semi Hu Chao-ish, sacrificing his own HP. Okay, and that's his burst. Oh, okay, so he enters like a super state. Okay, so yeah, he is going to be a 4-star DPS character. And he can spam his skill twice.
还可再次唤出文仔登场助力。
Oh, and he has like a little summon as well.
战斗真像看了一场武兽戏，
能让大伟哥有这样的观感。
I'm gonna get him just for the animations. I'm not gonna lie.
过程中，我们学习并借鉴了舞狮这门传统文化中的很多元素。
Yeah, he's like a lion dancer.
蹲桩、打滚、弓步。
Yeah, look at those animations.
再和现代元素相结合，想要为大家呈现出一种具有霓虹质感和火焰包裹的全新武兽戏。
印光武师，有心了，有心了，我感觉啊，确实挺新奇的。
另外，战斗聚焦在跳跃这个核心元素上呢，也是想给大家传达一种步步高升的节庆氛围。还有文仔的加入，也希望在补足连击丰富度的同时，呈现出双师合舞的感觉。
这要是再敲个锣、打个鼓啊，喜庆的节日感一下子就出来了啊。
是呀，而且说到海灯节，今年也有一位老朋友要来和我们一起。
Oh, yep.
我知道，那个女人。
Cloud Retainer, Lady Bird.
流云解封真君，果然大家都很喜欢她啊。
哎，说到流云真君啊，
Makes me wonder if the other Adepti are going to be like playable. Like Moon Carver and whatnot. Oh, wow. Wait, she can jump across water? Is that what I just saw her do?
Hello, 大家好呀。 现在玄云的开发进度已经接近尾声了，或许大家和我一样，也想知道研发同学们对这个角色。
Damn. Okay. I guess they just went above and beyond with Xianyun.
去采访一下他们吧。哎，同学，能和我们聊一聊制作玄云这个角色的初衷吗？啊，其实很久以前啊，我们就有了将流云这封真君化作人形游历世间的想法。啊，正好呢，恰逢这次海灯节，为了让他就是出现在今后的故事里面。 更加自然，更加顺畅吧。我们就借着这次机会呢，去把他的形象提升，并且给他。
So they're just like, yeah, we use Clavitator so many times. You might as well just make her a character, like an actual playable character at this point.
我就以下路攻击来举例吧。其实这个玩法在我们。
Cause yeah, she's really involved in like a lot of shit in Genshin.
所以这一次我们想尝试制作一个角色。
She can jump in the air, like. Okay, that's cool. Oh, she can turn any character into Xiao? With like, oh, that's gonna be really, really fun to play with.
谁不喜欢那个女人呢？因为组织安排。我不要。
Shut up and go back to your job. Mihoyo is like holding a gun to his head.
闲鱼又出 bug
了。机关树当时做起来其实并不是很容易，因为它不能太有科幻感，同时呢又要保持它的高级感。闲鱼的动作。
Yeah, they're really doing like a whole last section just for Xianyun. I guess it just goes to show how much effort they put into her. Hey, look, this guy's a Ganyu fan. Look at all the Ganyu merch in the background. Oh, wow, he also has a Xiao figure as well. I have the exact same Ganyu figure in my room right now. I guess there were a lot of like mishaps when it came to designing Xianyun. I really hope the guys at Hoyo are not overworked or anything like that. Boo! Terrible joke. It was a cute little section, just showing us like the development of Xianyun.
不愧是那个女人，就连制作幕后都这么有个性。说起来，这还是她第一次以人形。Yep,
there she is.
嗯，她这副打扮虽然之前出现过。I
don't recognize the English voice actor. I'm gonna have to look that up, like after this.
确实还是第一次。
看来这里面又有故事，那他今年打算怎么过节呢？这就要说到我们今年海灯节的主题——风筝。现在人间的机关造物可是越来越稀奇古怪。
Please tell me I should get to fly
kite。风筝，这也不算什么稀奇古怪吧？之前呢确实不算，但今年从枫丹那边引进了神奇的机械装置，能够让风筝无风自由，飞得又高又稳。你这么一说，我就懂了。
流云借风真君一定是起了莫名的攀比心吧，什么枫丹科技肯定比不过本仙的发明创造。看来大伟哥真的很熟悉这位老朋友啊，完全正确。So
she got jealous of Fontaine's technology, just wants to one up him.
敢爱敢恨，作风正直又富有侠义心肠，有时候好像有些心口不一，有时候又还有一点脱线。
可他的幽默总是能让人印象深刻。是的，虽然是个仙人呐，但非常有亲切感，真像是一位热心的邻居。
在流云界风真君以闲云之名正式入住离月港成为我们的邻居之前，他到底经历了些什么？大伟哥肯定也很好奇他过去的故事吧。哎呀，我的聊天讲故事的本事肯定没他好，不如到时候亲自去找他了解一下。
哎 okay, so she's getting a story quest. Nice.
海东杰以及贤鹤之章吧。
可以。
Just watch it be the whole thing, just her just talking about Ganyu and Shen, huh? That'd be so fucking funny.
我们是不是该改口叫他闲云了？
没错，那我也来分享一下闲云在战斗时的风采吧。
The secrets of the mechanical arts are too profound to convey in a few simple words. Oh, but why must the listener grow weary whenever I begin to divulge them?
Okay, her voice sounds very different from her bird form.
Skyward!
Yeah, the fact that she can just jump like that. Yeah, well, I wonder if that's gonna be like super useful, like traversal and whatnot. Oh yeah, but she has her little contraptions there to help her.
流云界风真君这个称号，再加上鹤的外形，不难让人联想出轻盈御风的仙人形象。闲云能进行至多三次的特殊跳跃，步天梯。
Sky Letter Leaps. Okay. So pretty much like three super jumps that you can do, I guess. Oh, her cranes are plunging attack. That's cool. That's very, very cool. Oh, okay. So she's a healer. Oh, but you can jump like super high while the perp burst is active. That's cool. I'm gonna make fucking plunging like Hu Tao a reality now. Like make her viable as plunging, as a plunging build.
就像是一位默默关照他人的热心长辈。
是的，希望能把闲云的这份人格魅力传递给大家。
那除了这两位有趣的角色之外，这次我们还有机会邀请到哪些角色入队呢？
那就来看看 4.4 版本的。
Oh yeah, wishes. Let's see him. 4.4
版本，闲云。
Oh, Nahida.
将会在第一。
Oh, and gaming champion on both their banners. Oh, gaming.
同时加名。
Didn't expect Nahida to have a rerun this early.
全新五星法器鹤鸣鱼鹰。
Hey, and there's her weapon. It's literally just like a paper fan.
在第二期活动祈愿中。
Xiao and Yaimiko, okay, completely the opposite of what my predictions were. I wonder why them. Yeah, why Yai and Nahida? Guess I haven't rerun in a while. But man, I can already tell for like new players, choosing between like Nahida and Xianyun is gonna be pretty difficult. Hey, there's the first redemption code, everybody! God, that's some really, really good art of Mommy Bird, as everybody's calling her. Okay, BBQAZ. Actually, I'll just put it down in the chat, just so you guys can copy and paste it. Actually, yeah, I have one of my mods to just type in, like, in the redemption code. Dear Traveler, wait, what? Wait, there's an official message by... Oh, wait, what? There's an errand expiration time. Oh. Wait, an error? Huh. I'm not sure what that's all about, but hopefully it doesn't affect the redemption code claiming. But yeah, there you go, folks. There's your redemption code, the very first one. Try and claim it while you can. Okay, and resume within 2 minutes. Okay, so that's a lot to unpack. So yeah, we got Gaming and Xianyun fan revealed, and the banners, Xianyun Nahida in phase one, with Gaming on both of their banners. Phase two is Xiao and Yaimiko. Interesting combination. I'm not sure why they are rerunning, but I guess it's been a while since you last saw them, huh? Nice, not bad banners. Oh yeah, we definitely gotta get into like the whole lantern fight stuff, because that's definitely coming back. Charlotte is coming to lantern, right? And it seems like, yeah, Ganyu and Shen have like new skins and everything. Like, yeah, Ganyu and Shen are both 5-stars, so this is gonna be like the first time we're getting like 2 5-star skins in a single update, isn't it? Yeah, I really want to like a better look at those skins, because yeah, I might just get them, especially for Ganyu. Shit. Yep, definitely gonna have to shell out some some jade, not jade, that's not real. Guy needs to definitely shell out some money for their skins. But yeah, Xianyun's gameplay looks kind of sick, honestly. So she can pretty much make anybody like just a plunge character. So Plunge Hu Tao could definitely be viable. I wonder what other characters can be pretty good with like a plunge build. BBQ and Q, yeah, and Q no Z. I just realized this is like, yeah, barbecue, huh? Like, what's up with this redemption code? Yeah, I'm trying to look at the characters that released recently and see which ones would be good with a plunging build. Ooh, I kind of want to do Plunge Ito. Some part of me wants to do Plunge Ito. Plunge Wanderer could be fun, I guess. Like when his skill's on cooldown. Or heck, Plunge Rite and Shogun. The possibilities are endless of that. And yeah, she can jump up like super high and like, which is good for traversal. Then in the end, there's also Gaming, whose playstyle looks pretty fun, I'm gonna be honest. I definitely want to test that out and like play for myself, especially for his animations. Yeah, definitely can't wait to pull for them. Thank God Gaming is on Sienna's banner though, so I can try getting them both. I'm guessing there's more music that's gonna be in Chenyuvale or the other place I forget the name of already. Xiaoming Village, yeah. Or Xiaoying Village. Chao can plunge? Oh yeah, it's not gonna work with him. But it's gonna work with most other characters. This is some good music right here.
大伟哥, 你感觉陈玉谷的景色怎么样?
我还没看到太多, 目前感觉还挺美的。
Yeah, please show us more of Xianyin Village. It looks so pretty.
大伟哥爱提敏锐,
and Chenyu Vale as well.
流传着很多与仙人有关的传说, 还真有点世外桃源的味道。
是吧? 而且目前看来啊, 陈玉谷这边的人文建筑, 好像都有点, 徽派建筑的味道。
没错, 没错, 就拿俏英庄来说吧。
Oh, wow, that looks pretty. It's also like very distinct from, Like, yeah, it's also like seems very, very distinct from, what's that place? Qingsei Village, Qingsei Village, right. I almost forgot the name. Okay, there better be a chest behind that waterfall. Yilong Wharf.
Oh. Yeah,
Oh, okay. A carp death tie known as Fujin.
Huh.
Wait, oh, we're also getting Yilong Wharf as well? Holy shit, how much of Liyue is being expanded? Yeah, how big is this Liyue expansion being? Okay, not Liyue copying Fontaine with like the massive tower?
而且这瀑布之下还有一条蜿蜒曲折的大河贯穿整个陈玉谷。
Holy shit, the boats are actually moving. This is revolutionary.
大伟哥应该也注意到河道上那对巨大的玉骨。
What the fuck are those？
那里就是宝爵口
Jade Mouth，
玉骨中最有名的地标之一了。
The, what giant thing made this?
应该也是过去的仙人留下的吧。像这么壮观又瑰丽的景色，应该也只有仙人能创造出来吧。
传说宝爵口的这对玉珏。
Oh wow, that scenery looks really, really good.
凭智烙而投下的。
哈哈，心系人民的仙人确实还挺值得大家敬爱啊。这里的种种传说啊，听上去感觉还挺浪漫的。
是的，我们也来看看陈玉谷的其他地方吧，像柠檬山。是历史悠久的古
巴的 origin of the Gua clan.
Oh,
so we get to visit the origins of St. Joe's place.
还有南方的赤章成员是属于
Dude, how big is this leeway expansion being?
还真辽阔啊。
和刚才说的
I thought it was just only going to be Chenyu and Qing and Xiaoying village, but it seems to be much more.
说不定就散落在这雾气缭绕的高山之间呢。
你别说，陈玉谷也有不少高山。但我总感觉和以往常见到的璃月山岩还不太一样。
陈玉谷这边的山岭更像是峰峦叠嶂的黄山，这些山峦的颜色好像是水墨画一样。
Yeah, that's such a cool looking fucking shot.
灵动的青色晕染，再加上山岭之间还藏着各种各样的奇特景观，我就觉得呀。
Oh yeah, look at this place. Is this an actual place we can just explore?
流传后世。和这种独一无二的地理风貌应该是
I thought it was like part of a domain or something, but it seems we can just freely come in here.
当你漫游陈玉谷的时候，登临山岭高处，就会看到那些跌宕起伏的云海，根据日光的变化，呈现出异彩纷呈的华美景象。
Wow. God, Hoyo just kills it when it comes to fucking their world design.
你也太会描述景色了，说的我的
God damn.
期待都挖满了。
还不止这些哦，除了仙迹和美景
，Like Fontaine was amazing, but you can't deny how beautiful Liwei looks.
比如隐山。
Ah, that's a new boss. I'm guessing you have to kill this thing or beat this thing up multiple times for Xianyun stuff. Yeah, he looks like an animal boss.
虽然说是传说中的祥瑞之兽，但若是有人贸然闯入他们的领地，打扰他们的安宁。
Well, I guess that means I can pre-farm for Xianyun in advance.
他的外形啊，包括战斗表现都好仙好灵哦，我喜欢。
顺带一提，仪农部家喻户晓的武兽戏，这就是以传说中离兽的形象为原型进行的表演。家明身边的文仔其实也是离兽哦。
看来这之间也有故事啊。
那就来看看隐山离兽的故事吧。
Solitary Swanee.
Oh, that's quite the inquiry.
No.Oh!
So are the stories true, sir?
Is this like paper animation? Oh, this is cool! Aww!
The discussion of this beast must first begin with Chenyu Vale, a land of tiered peaks shrouded in billowing mist, replete with stories of illuminated beasts. As for the subject of your curiosity...
Yeah, this seems like paper animation, and not like a regular Genshi cutscene. Swanee.
It is a symbolic and auspicious animal, said to be related to the Adepti. Legends say the Swanee traverses the land under the cover of mist. Its presence nearly indetectable, save only for the faintest outline of horns. When at ease, it rests with eyes closed and legs crossed. Yet should the situation turn dangerous, the fury of the Swanee will be unleashed.
Oh shit.
The swiftness of wind swept
the fucking music.
Attacks with the ferocity of a roaring waterfall. But some people say this time of peace has forced the Swanee into a life of seclusion far beyond our reach. Still, those are just a few old legends I've heard.
I like this little, like, banner that Gaming has.
The Wushou dance might prove tricky.
It's like anything. Practice makes perfect. I just gotta work at it. You see? Manzai agrees with me.
Manzai? Is that... I'm guessing that's his name. Man, he looks adorable. I want a plushie of it now.
就连香茶的气味也变得不如从前了。 到时候还烦请各位旅行者跟随仙人的指引，帮助解决困扰。
So, to judge by that story, we're beating up a fucking adeptus.
再次感谢两位同学给我们带来了这么精彩的成语谷介绍。
Which kind of seems fucked up.
那接下来我们稍作休息，准备了解一下今年海灯节的活动吧。
Ah, damn it! Of course, they're gonna save that for like the very end. Well, there's second redemption code. Damn, our second one already. Before we get to the big stuff. Yeah, there you go. Like, yeah. That's... Yeah, those are definitely new outfits for Shenhe and Ganyu. Yeah, they look very, very much similar to, like, Kuching's black outfit. Well, not really, but... Yeah, we definitely gotta get a better look at these outfits. I'm for 100% sure gonna get both of them, though. But yeah, there's your second redemption code, folks. Claim it within 12 hours, otherwise it's gonna expire. MT. Hold up. MT88. Hold up. AY. HCZ. 2. UR. I hope I typed that right. What a beautiful boss, we're gonna slaughter it. Yeah, I kind of feel bad for beating up.
接下来就让我们和阿明一起来看看今年的海灯节。
I'm gonna feel real bad for beating that thing multiple times for the Cloud Retainer.
我还真挺期待今年海灯
节。Alright, tell us about Lantern Rite.
会有些什么样的惊喜呢？
那么我就来抛砖引玉一下。刚才阿然也提到，今年海灯节的主题是风筝，还将里月的传统手工艺风筝与
It's gonna be a kite mini game.
垂直拉升装置进行了结合。
机械风筝，不知道和流云真君的机关比起来，哪个技术力更强啊？
这可不好说呀。
哎，我小时候也放过风筝，但其实我对风筝了解不是特别多。为什么会选用风筝来当主题呢？
Man, I also used to fly kites as well. Wonder how long it's been since I've flown one.
这倒是和萧灯有异曲同工之妙啊。
I feel like the last time I flew a kite was like I was 10.
不过我们这次的风筝在晚上也会发光哦。
我们平时最常见的风筝应该是飞鸟图案吧。我记得有传说是古人受到飞鸟启发，创作了风筝，表达对美好生活的追求。
哎，是啊，我以前放的也是燕子风筝，
不过现在已经有很多不同样式的风筝了。
There's a wobble flower kite and there's a jade chamber kite.
比如锦鲤、龙凤、彩蝶，这些图案都
很。Oh yeah, those look pretty cool.
除了表达美好的祝愿，也能让看到的人们感受到祝福。
I flew one the other day. It's now one with the wind.
非常有益身心的活动。
I'm sorry, Fifi.
在海灯节里体验体验。
而且在今年海灯节上，甘雨和申鹤将会穿着流云借风真君请人特别定制的新衣装。
Oh yeah, please show us the new outfits like in better detail.
同时，行秋。
Wait, Singchul's getting a new outfit too? We're getting three new outfits this update?
就能够免费。
Not like the usual two?
那快看看老。
Oh, okay. Singchul's is free, but Ganyu's and Shenhe's are paid. I see.He has a tiny ponytail. Oh, wait, is that a fontaine outfit he's wearing? Oh, yeah, it totally is. Oh, Ganyu, my beloved. Oh my god, that looks so good on her. Okay, she's definitely showing a lot more thigh in this outfit. And then Shenhe, too. Oh my god, look at her. Oh, yeah, with the fucking black dress. That looks so good.Shit, my wallet's gonna be drained. Holy shit, look at that fucking statue though.
确实好看，明明是来给大
家介绍海灯节。Shit, I'm gonna have to get them both Ganyu's and Shenhe's, because they just look so good.
海灯节上都有一些什么有意思的活动吧？
好嘞。
今年海灯节上
，Yeah, all three of them just have their thighs just hanging right out.
指引巡游、瑞兽欢悦和异光云行。
感觉光听名字就能有一个模糊的概念了。
他们的灵感源自各种传统文化，不过我们就像客卿一样。
Where are the pants? Well, they're wearing pants. They're just very, very short.
快讲讲怎么个推陈出新法？
那先来说说这个指引巡遥吧。拆解名字的话，就是用指引的形式来寻觅佳肴。璃月。
Oh, hey, paper theater. Wasn't this like a thing back?
灵活运用画片。
Like back in the previous Lantern, right?
画面在幕布上活起来。再结合枫丹的映影相关技术，改编成一种新颖的互动游戏，叫做 剪纸戏，主要会讲述些简单明快的故事，让观众们会心一笑。
我大概有概念了啊，结合这张锅巴和月桂的图啊，这出剪纸戏应该是引导锅巴和月桂去找食材来做美食的故事吧。
哎，被大伟哥猜对了。
没错没错，这个活动玩法呢，操作上比较简单，老少皆宜。我们需要控制锅巴和月桂
，What the fuck？
在特定的步数限制下解开谜题，破除障碍，最后一起收集到食材，就可以成功烹饪出各种美味佳肴了。
Okay, so it's pretty much a kid's puzzle.
门槛不高，玩一遍应该就会了，确实很有节庆气氛。
不过呢，也不要太过小看这个游戏了。在后几关挑战中，可能需要引导锅巴与月桂互相配合。
Oh damn！
让锅巴去推动月桂乘坐的小车，这样月桂就能在不同的起始点开始行动，也能节省下一些步数。
有意思，像是推箱子一样。
第二个活动，瑞兽欢悦。
Joyful beasts and their auspicious。
在兽系的基础上进行了简化以及趣味性改良的碰碰舞兽。
Just Wushu dance。
希望大家能够在茶余饭后
rip off of Just Dance，
同时也能亲身感受一下舞兽系的魅力。
哎，不错哎，舞兽系啊，看着就挺有意思的。但要自己去体验舞兽门槛还是有点高的，那这个趣味活动啊，说不定能给我们带来不一样的火花。
这个火花可是靠碰撞出来的哦。这个活动共有三个关卡，力士连连来，时节竞登高，彩青争
霓裳。 It's a co-op challenge, OK.
可以通过匹配让店家帮忙组局，也可以自行邀请亲朋好友组团游玩。当进入关卡场地后，我们需要在限定时间内达成不同的关卡目标，尽可能取得更高的评分。在这个过程中还可以穿戴特制的舞兽系玩偶服。
OK. So it's pretty much like the other like co-op events almost.
确实很欢乐。而且在游玩过程中还可以稍微使点小坏，弹开其他朋友来争夺更多的积分。
you can fucking send your friends flying.
他们大概宁愿不去抢机
会。I want to see what that looks like.
那也不能光顾着使坏啊。三个关卡还是有一些特定规则的，比如力士连连来最容易上手，最重要的目标就是去争夺尽可能多的力士茶饼。
Okay, collect shit.
的玩家也能获得他掉落的茶饼。时节竞登高，还额外要去抢占时不时出现的高地来保持豪气值，同时也可以通过弹开别的玩家让他抢。
So you just knock people off your stage, okay?
不时刷新的安全区域。
That's kind of fun, honestly.
麻辣气氛的影响。从而保持清淡值。当然，既然出现了安全区域，
也就是说可以去弹开。
I don't know a lot of people like co-op gamers, but this one seems super fun, honestly.
麻辣锅去充饥是吧？
好像大伟哥已经懂了，领先损友一步。
And honestly, I can't see how this event will be fun playing it alone. Oh.
可以借助金鲤浮月的力量，在烟花绽放的。
Oh, you play as a fish and collect lanterns.
收集尽可能多的玉莲灯笼来积累得分。还请放心，金鲤会一直保护我们。不会让烟花伤害到我们的。
化为金鲤穿梭于烟花绽放的夜空中，听起来就很浪漫。
希望海灯节的故事与活动能把这份喜庆又吉祥的节日气氛传达给每一位旅行者。当节庆热度
I do wonder though. Oh yep, there you go. Choose a free four star. As per always. And yeah, definitely gonna go for Gaming, cause he's like the wonder character.
加名哦。
That all of us don't have.
Oh,
yeah, okay, so there's the previews of their outfits. Dude, they look so, so good. Definitely gonna have to get by both their outfits, because I do use them both actively.
Gonna
have to go back to being a Ganyu main again. Oh, yeah, we're also getting a free temple as in this event, as for all lantern rites.
没错，也祝愿各位能和亲朋好友一同享受欢乐的时光。
说的对啊，不过我们的节目还没有结束。
Yeah, Lanterite really do be like the original anniversary.
第三组兑换码吧。
Oh, they're revealing more stuff. I'm guessing they're gonna reveal like the filler events and whatnot. Dude, what? Who is this guy? What is this? The only god of Liyue? Who the heck is that supposed to be? I want to know more about this guy.He looks fucking awesome. But yeah, so 100% gonna buy both of their outfits. Yeah, this is also the first time we're getting three outfits in a single update, because usually it's like two, like per update where we get skins. But now we're getting, yeah, Sing Shows for free. Ganyu's enchantos, which you do need to pay for, which I will because I use them both actively. And plus, I kind of collect skins in this game anyways. But yeah, cannot wait for this update to go up. So yeah, we're getting like a Liyue expansion, we're getting Xianyun and Gaming. We're getting Lantern Ride, we're getting fucking everything. Probably now that Adeptus done dirty, or fallen. Yeah, probably so. They seem to like do that for like every Lantern Ride, like introduce a new Adeptus that's like fallen in the past. Xingqiu looks adorable. Can't wait for a similar outfit for Wanderer. Yeah, I do wonder what a Wanderer outfit is gonna be a thing. Cause I would buy a Wanderer outfit so fast, you wouldn't even believe. I do find it kind of weird though. They're bringing Ganyu Shenhe outfits, but Ganyu and Shenhe are not on the banners. Like what? Also, when was the last time Ganyu and Shenhe had a banner? Watch those sly fucks at Hoyo put Ganyu and Shenhe in 4.5. Just to make people buy the outfit, then get the character. Cause yeah, when was the last time Ganyu and Shenhe were rerun? I think like a while now, right? Cause they were not in any of the Fontaine up banners, right? I'm not mistaken, am I? Also, this is some pretty dark gun music, I gotta say. Dude, I can already see myself just chilling at Chenyu Vale, or Xiaoming Village, or wherever this is, just to listen to this music. Yeah, Genshin always makes the best, like, relaxing musics.
Hey, 大伟哥, 你知不知道, 里月现在已经吸引到越来越多不同地区的朋友前来游玩了。
当然知道, 上次温迪不就来海灯节了吗?
Please let Furina come to the Lantern, right?
是啊。 今年的话，不仅有一些朋友会来里月共度海灯节，还有其他熟人来到了望舒客栈。这是来尝里月菜来了。虽然可能初衷不是这种。
Oh, I would so love it if like yeah the Fontaine of like and characters from other regions came to Font came to Liyue. Sorry, a receiver of friends from afar. Oh, this is another event. Okay, so it's not connected to the Lantern, right? I'm guessing it's gonna be like the Liyue equivalent of the bartender event, where just random characters from afar just come over to say hi.
Ah.
From Monset, Sumeru, Inazuma, and Fontaine. So we're pretty much cooking for the characters. Yep. Exactly like the bartender event, but slightly different.
来烹饪出符合客人需求的菜肴，最后进行摆盘装饰，就可以邀请。
Oh fuck! This event is gonna make me hungry. It's bad enough that the food in Genshin already makes me hungry as is. What the fuck? Who's this amateur? Journey through the enigmatic terrain. The shit? The Halo started stirring up trouble again?
This时候就需要我们前去调查其中暗藏的真相和秘密了，对吧？没错。
大伟哥已经是一位非常优秀的旅行者了，毕竟也旅行了这么久。我们需要先操控乌帕诺之眼，依附在秋秋人与风帆身上，潜入部落营地中，同时需要小心地避开或者干扰那些能识破我们伪装的秋秋萨满，直到抵达营地深处，找到并调查那些神秘的雕像。这潜行好流畅啊！调查完雕像后
，It's an interesting looking event.
等待我们的僵尸一族。Oh fucking hell, okay.
That Samatro's way bigger than I thought.
Jesus
Christ.
转化为我们的武器。
Yeah, kill it with fire.
例如击破他召唤的六倍大日落果，使他在地面残留的果汁中摔倒，把他召唤的。
Why is all the food here so huge?
还有利用他召唤的大型风场飞起来，并使用下落攻击的冲击波战胜他。
This event also turns everybody into shell.
听起来很刺激啊。
除了丘丘人部落的神秘雕像，在波诡云爵的秘境深处。
Triumphant Frenzy, ooh. I'm guessing this is a combat event. This pretty much randomized Abyss. So it just randomly selects trial characters, okay. So it's not your own characters, it's trial characters. And then you choose four of the following. Alright, a randomized domain challenge. Those are usually fun, at least for me. TCG updates. Oh, Toma and Sayu card. Nice. I definitely gotta catch up with TCG. I haven't even gotten like Yelan's card or any of the other cards that have been out for a while. Oh, Overlook Mastery as well. Nice. Oh yeah, the loadout system. It's finally here. Thank God. Thank the lords above that it's finally here. Yeah, this was said in one of the Hoyo dev posts. Finally, after 3 years. Now, can we get more resin as well, please? Okay, I guess not. I guess that about does it for this live stream. What the fuck? Oh, this is the phone collab. What is that Kaching outfit though? Wait, that's different from our normal black dress. When are we gonna get that skin in the game? Exceeds the speed of lightning with one plus. God, I don't know why Genshin does so many phone collabs. I mean, I guess they do work sometimes. No, more OST, nice. Yes, more Fontaine OST on Spotify. Hell yeah. Is that all? Nothing about the anime? Even after all this time? I know anime take a while to make, but at least some information would have been nice. Oh well, bad luck next time, I guess. Happy Lantern Rite! Ah, damn. I thought they would announce a bit more. Like, more stuff, like the anime and whatnot, but for what we got, it's pretty good. It feels like they're edging us when it comes to the anime. Like, literally no news. At least an update would be nice of, like, how the progress is. Ah, there you go. Well, it's confirmed, ladies and gentlemen. 4.4 is going to be a Lantern Rite update. So, I guess let's take a moment to, like, recap everything that happened. So, banner-wise, or character-wise, we're getting Gaoming and Xianyun in 4.4. Xianyun's and Nahida's banners will be in phase 1 along with Gaoming on both of their banners. And then in phase 2, it'll be Yai, Miko, and Xiao in the phase 2 banners of 4.4. We're getting the Lantern Rite event, which we can get a free Sing Cho skin. And you can also get like a free Tenpo if you log in daily. We're also getting a Shenhe and Ganyu skin. which are both paid, which I probably will get both of them, honestly, because I main them a lot. What else? Oh yeah, we also have the event, a cooking event, where it seems like it's the Mossad equivalent, or the Leeway equivalent of the bartender event, where just random characters from abroad just come over to like try your dishes or your drinks and whatnot. So yeah, that one's gonna be fun. We also have a combat event, which like randomizes the characters seemingly. And then we also have an event where we can beat up a giant salmon troll. And of course, the talent book event is also coming back as well. Yeah, the double talent book event is also coming back. And then other than that, it's... am I missing anything? Oh yeah, we are getting a story quest for Xianyun, aka Cloud Retainer. We're getting that as well, but I think other than that, there's nothing else. There's nothing else I'm missing, right? Oh yeah, we're getting more areas in Leeway. How could I forget? We're getting more areas in Leeway in the form of Tiaoying Village, Chenyu Vale, and a bunch of other locations as well. So yeah, we're getting a bit of an expansion to Leeway, seemingly like around the Qingzhe Village area, which I cannot wait for. And we're also getting a new boss, which I assume you have to beat it multiple times to get Xianyun's materials. But yeah, that does it for the version 4.4 special program. I don't think I've missed anything else. What are you guys' thoughts on this live stream? I think this is a pretty good live stream overall. Also, yeah, we also are getting the artifact loadout changes and everything. Finally, after 3 years of this game being out. And yeah, as usual, in Land to Ride, you get to pick a free 4-star if you're choosing. And Gaming is also included in those 4-star options. So... If you want Gao Ming but you don't want Xianyun, you can always just get him for free in the free 4-star event in Lantern Rite. But yeah, what are you guys' thoughts on 4.4? I'm definitely excited for it for sure, but I don't know, I just kind of expect a bit more from this live stream because it was a dev stream. Maybe that's just me, but yeah. Overall, I'm still very much excited for 4.4. Cannot wait to pull for Gao Ming and Xianyun. Cannot wait to play Lantern Rite and also get the Ganyu and Shenhe skins. And yeah, just can't wait for this patch overall in like, what, 10 days from now? Or 11 days, actually. But yeah, cannot wait for this update. Hope you guys are excited for it, too. And yeah, I think with all that said, I think that's where we're going to conclude it for our watch party for the Genshin 4.4 special program. What are your thoughts on this live stream? Be sure you leave your thoughts in the comments or the chat down below. But yeah, guys, with all that said, thank you all so much for watching, and we'll see you guys again in the next one. Take care, and have good nights. And I'll see you all again on Monday, hopefully.